really cool theory from Duren Rutter. Wanted to share it.
This is just a theory I've got. We were just chatting before it. My theory is that unless someone's sweating out the salt, then they're going to be holding a lot of water retention. And my theory is that when you've sweated out all the last bit of salt gunk, this is again theory, my theory, my little observation, not backed by any clinical science like the other stuff I promote, but this is, I believe that if someone's still tasting salt on their lips, or if they lick their sweat or whatever, that they can still taste salt, and they're not eating any salt anymore, other than in the fruits and vegetables, or they're not having any salt shakers or seaweed, yeah. If they can still taste the salt, they're not eating the salt, then they've still got a lot of water retention to get rid of, a lot of salt retention to get rid of. Right. So the best way to get rid of that is through sustained activity at a moderate level heart rate, a heart rate that's difficult to talk at, you can still talk at, or a heart rate where you don't really want to talk at. It's really hard to talk. So, and it's not about going to Bikram yoga and just sweating out. I'm talking like high heart rate, breathing hard, sweat, outdoor fresh air style. That's my little theory I'm putting out there, that if you can still taste salt on your lip when you're training and you're not eating salt, then you've got salt retention to get rid of. That's my theory.
Well, yeah, so it sounds like, like where I'm at, which is, I'm doing the raw lifestyle, well. And, I've dropped some weight, but I still have some weight to go. And I haven't reached my fitness goals yet. Mm-hmm. And I definitely taste salt on my lips. So it's interesting. I've never heard this theory before. I guess I just need to push it, It's easy to stay where you're comfortable, right? But I guess you really need to push it.
Definitely, it's like push it consistently, though, versus just push it for a month and burn out. I'm saying like push it hard for the next few years, being 95% of your training volume is easy where you can comfortably talk, and 5% of your training is where it's very uncomfortable to talk, if not like difficult to talk, where you don't want to talk. So 5% hard, 95% easy.
So we were like doing sprints earlier. I keep covering the thing. We were doing sprints earlier up like the big hill.
Yeah.
And so if we did like 10 of those, like, I don't know. So you're saying like maybe one day is intense and then the rest of the days is like moderate?
Yeah. Well, so what you could do is calculate the time that hill sprints took. Maybe today 5 minutes intensity.
Yeah, something like that.
So then the rest of the week you're going to be going pretty easy.
Okay. Well, great advice as usual.
Yeah. So 10% of 5 hours is like, what is it? 5% of 10 hours.
You want me to do math? Okay, wait.
It's 10%. That's not a lot of time. I'm going to calculate it. It's maybe 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes a week should be hardcore, and the rest of the 10 hours or 5 hours should be talking level. Nice. We can talk comfortably.
Yeah. And if that strikes fear in you, what I found is like, and I think most people, when you really sprint and when you really push it, it's like so joyful. We're sprinting, we're laughing, and we're, it's like, you release something when you're really sprinting that you don't release when you're, like, slowly jogging. Not only are you pushing it, but you're, like, reaching more into your potential as a human being. And it, for some reason, it just makes you joyful.
It's meditation. Yeah. It's active meditation.
There you go. Sure.